Hi, I'm Danielle DeCesaro, and in this video, I'll be discussing reducing cell culture contamination using aseptic technique. Good aseptic technique starts before you even enter the lab. This is performed by first washing your hands, then donning personal protective equipment or PPE, such as gloves, lab jacket, and glasses. And these are worn in order to reduce contamination from yourself, your skin cells, and your hair. Proper aseptic technique involves having a clean biosafety cabinet and proper PPE donned before entering the biosafety cabinet, which includes gloves, lab jacket, and glasses. Then, upon entering the biosafety cabinet, you will clean with IPA solution and wipe the surface until dry. Then, every item that enters the biosafety cabinet, with priority headed to wrapped items and items that exited the fridge, will be sprayed down. And wiped to remove the condensation. Any spills that occur will be wiped up immediately with the wipers. You remove the items as you need them, and anything else leaves the biosafety cabinet if it's not needed. To aseptically transfer, you should always pipette, which means never pouring. So to remove media from your bottle into another flask, you'll use sterilizable pipettes, either glass or disposable. Always holding the cap. If you need to place the cap down, do so face down on the hood, which has been cleaned. Ideally, you won't touch the serological pipette to the inside of a bottle, but if you need to do so, you do it on what is the bottle where the media is being transferred. And don't allow the pipette to touch the interior of the vessel. Pipettes will then go into a marked container, either biosafety or just a glass bin. Spills are wiped up, and you close your containers, and then exit the biosafety cabinet. Remember to perform experiments as quickly as possible in order to reduce contamination. Thank you.